I'm Patrick Quillen, and you and I are getting healthier together. I'd like to share with you right now some ideas about Mother Nature knows best. Do not question Mother Nature and its incredible intelligence. For instance, if we go back into nutrition history, we find that the early nutritionists said, you know, we find calories in food. We can put it in a bomb calorimeter, and we can measure the calories, and we can match that. When we take mother's milk, we'll match it with something else. Didn't work very well. A lot of infants died. And they said, well, wait a minute, there's more to that. Why don't we find protein? And they found carbohydrates and fat. All right, now we know everything that we need to know about food, and we can simulate it. No, they couldn't. And then they said, now, wait a minute. If we take the bran out of wheat, since it's indigestible, you can't digest it, what good is it? So we'll throw it away, and we're actually doing you a favor. Wrong. What they found is the diseases of civilization escalated dramatically when they took fiber out of food. Mother Nature knows best. And then the experts said, you know, you don't need this stuff. We can, Tang. It's nothing more than flavoring, coloring, and powdered vitamin C, and that's all you need. And then they said, you know, wait a minute. Actually, there's bioflavonoids and carotenoids that are in whole oranges that go above and beyond simple vitamin C. And then they said, you know, I think we know everything about food. Well, wait a minute. Actually, when you absorb food, the RNA, the ribonucleic acid, and the DNA are actually being absorbed into the bloodstream, and they become bioregulators. I didn't know that. And then they said, we know everything there is about food. No, wait a minute. We find that people who eat more cruciferous vegetables, broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, have a much lower risk of cancer. And then they found this sulforaphane thing in there. Oh, I didn't know that was there. So I'm not criticizing anybody for their quest. I applaud science and its progress. What I'm making a point of right now is arrogance and ignorance. When people say we think we know it all, we don't. And every time we question Mother Nature, we come up with another major health dilemma. What I'm sharing with you is the idea of whole foods. Now we're looking at diets, saying, well, you know, I don't think we should eat fat. Ansel Keys was one of the founders of the theory that fat was killing us. And somebody in the back of the room said, but Eskimos eat 60% of their calories from fat, and they have no heart disease and no cancer. You know, you're right. Maybe there's good fats. And then they realize, you know, actually saturated fats are neutral in this whole business of heart disease. And the Framingham study, arguably the most expensive and broad scope study done in America, found that there was no relationship between saturated fat intake and heart disease. What I'm sharing with you is, look at Mother Nature. How did our ancestors adapt and evolve? What was their diet? And I'm not talking about 50 years ago living on hog fat and rhubarb pie. I'm talking about 5,000 years ago. And so we can go back to a model of saying Mother Nature knows best. You'll find that your health improves dramatically. I'm Patrick Quillen, and you and I are getting healthier together.